Dota 2 skins and play on the following game modes. They have Jackpot, Crash, Roulette, Trade Up, and Hilo. All of these game modes are ensured with a provably fair system to ensure all of the games you're playing on are fair. If you are interested in checking out Gamnom.com, make sure to check out the link in the description.
I'm okay, and I will say, PYW has been
gonna run past PYW with the Orb of Venom. So 5 minutes in, and so far, very even across the lanes. It looked a little bit funky at the start, but it's kind of all settled a bit since then. Although, actually, say that, Yang, in some troubles. Heavenly Grace takes it off, and it looks like he is going to be able to walk away. So knowing the limits of that hero with PYW in tow.
Yeah, you have to, like, Puck in the offlane is very aggressive. Like, you have such high right-click damage, and obviously you're really survivable, but you can never feed. If you feed on this, you've just kind of like given away part of this.
Speaking of feeding.
The level one Heavenly Grace comes into play again. And that's the first feed, as they feast upon the first blood of PYW. And Tim's trying to get this disruptor position four off to a good start.
So, you know, we've been keeping our eyes on all of this stuff top lane.
Yeah.
But you see down bottom here, Urus has been able to get some pressure on, but now overextending a little bit. Tries to go for the stun, pump fakes it. Armel tanking through a lot of damage. Needs to be careful with this one,
so
as he's facing into him the whole time.
VG have a plan. They knew that this rotation was coming from Armel.
Gets the kill.
Oh, jeez. Okay. Well, they knew this rotation was coming bottom because about... I don't recall seeing that one yet.
This guy does his homework. All right. Fissure block off at the same time as Thunderstrike comes through, and they just kill Yang. Well, eventually it was bound to happen as they have the Glimpse pull back in onto PYW, but with the Heavenly Grace status resistance, they won't be able to finish him off.
Rylaning this whole time, right? Like, March is almost 4.5 right now. Tim's over level 4. Meanwhile, DY's struggling, just running around. Yeah, I mean, he's trying to get 4, but he's been alone for the most part.
Urus trying to move in and contest Armel. He needs to be careful, though. Armel is 3 levels ahead of him. But Lesh just
and
doing
now
so much damage. He's in some trouble as he wants to kill him up. Armel getting super duper low. Does he manage to get away? 4 HP! And he is going to escape just barely. KP ends up securing that kill with a tower hit of all things.
And the worst part is that they can see him doing
Song
that.
And runs away and is not going to be caught.
Yeah, D1 not able to get the respect off in time there.
And Yang now going to be ran down by Armel. Everywhere you look, VG Gaming are just getting bodied.
The 10 minute comes out here. I don't know how much they can contest here. This is a little bit dangerous.
Oh, Fissure block. And we'll see if March is going to be quick enough on the fingers. Enchant Totem wants to get it. March takes the bounty rune. And that's going to be a 3-for-1. Although he will lose, the silence comes out, but they can't really do anything to continue to gank that Morphling. He just walks away from it.
Meanwhile, the bottom, though, KP getting caught here. They know there's no song.
And he's going to die. So a good pickup as Urus is able.
Playing Puck, you know, you'd expect maybe him to be a bit more survivable.
Armel gonna start to put the goo on the PYW as two heroes head through the mid lane, Yang and Ori. Getting some pressure on. They drop the coil now. Need to be careful as
they're
they do
beating.
Have Static Storm into the middle of all of them. They pull him back in. There's a Heavenly Grace. Is it going to be enough? No. They get the kill onto Yang. Bristle turns his back, but is not going to be able to coil. No,
the
stick
wand.
Charges. And the song is there. And March walking in for the Echo Slam. Does he hit it onto all of them? Is it going to be enough? Yes, indeed. The captain makes it happen. But can they kill the rest of these heroes off? They lose the Urshaker. Armel airily able to walk away from it. Tries to turn on to Urus. It's not going to happen. So they only end up getting the Lion kill on
and
top of
the
it.
Yules.
Although Armel is now in some trouble. Purification comes out. Tim's wanting to make it happen. But Vici, make the kill work.
Got that Deso first. Grant, I can hear him cheering in the back. Not the blink first. And Gabby didn't see that one coming.
Uh-oh.
The finger guns coming out from DY. Put one on the counter. And he'll have Auras 2 on this offlane Naga. So no like immediate dispel to help you out, but still some nice tools.
Runs into Urus. Might buy his Vanguard on his way out. Yule Scepter. Stun. Connected. Fissure out. Follow-up stun. Ori hits on the both of them. The triple side plates. Oh,
jeez.
Line up.
That's the big thing. Right now, lots of sentries down from the side of TNC. Heavily invested in keeping this area safe from Gabby because He needs to know that he can farm at max speed. It's so important for this Morphling, right? Like, he's the key to this whole strategy, so he wants to be at just, like, as much agi as possible this entire time.
Armel trying to be the one that stands in front. DY throws out the stun. They don't want to let that finger get used, and it won't happen as they take him down.
Yeah, DY. Oh, no, they won't. They'll run back towards Armel.
Okay, going for him. Finger of Death is out as well as the Hex. Trying to take him down, but Fissure is going to interrupt, and now the turnaround. They get the GA out to try and keep him alive. Static Storm as well as the Ensnare onto Yang, so they are going to keep Armel survivable. Meanwhile, the stun comes out there on the other side. Marth trying to move
Morph.
In. Nickel Slam isn't going to work. Morph switches over to the side, takes down Urus. What a player. PYW trying to run away with the GA already gone. They will kill off that Earthshaker. Can they have the control left over for Ori? KP, one more swipe is going to do it. But Armel now big, bad, and angry. He's going to try and turn on to them. Gabby has already taken down a couple in this, and his eyes are next set onto Ori. But it's really dangerous walking onto him. And Yang, actually over on the side here, could be...
Right now. Like, this Earthshaker should not be able to stand there, but thankfully Yang can... DY, come on, bud.
Juke's around the corner, and the Song of the Siren's gonna come out.
Is that really a juke?
Keeping him caught. I mean, you gotta call it where you can get it, right? KP's gonna try and turn now, so you can find Fissure. A little bit off the mark there. Did connect on a PYW, but Mark's still in a lot of trouble. Silence gets the Echo Slam out. Over on the middle of the fight, they're gonna blow up Yang.
Good.
Now the follow-up, Tim's in some trouble, will go down. KP wanting to turn on to PYW, and with Armel here, this looks like it's more than enough. They're trying to burn through all of that mana, but a double kill comes out from Gabby. Armel, super duper low, trying to walk away. Is he going to be able to make it? Gabby in the back line's just dismantling them. He's switching back over to the other form, getting a little bit more strength. They again keep the bristle alive.
They're going to dive. Here they come. And then he saves March. March holding that Echo, waiting until he'd have a chance. And well, so the save might have been for naught here.
He got a bonnet grip.
Yeah, all right, fair enough. Again.
He's a working... Oh, look at the juke. Oh, you can't handle me.
Oh,
my name is March.
Ankles are broken.
Whatever.
If I'm them, I want to go for a kill pretty soon, right? I want to try and set up for this next Rosh. I want to get some aggressive vision for my team.
And March gets found. He is going to be brought down. And again, we've talked about this before, but it makes a little bit of sense why he's out.
Although, yeah, they have that vision in the river from TNC. You do have the vision, likewise, in the high ground. Not covered by a sentry from TNC, despite there being about 2 million of them placed down throughout this game.
Hello! Welcome to the Pain House.
I don't think it was him. He was who's going to press the button, and perhaps who won't?
Oh, God. Armel's walking in. You got to be careful. Morph also just hit level 18. AP is there as well. Jump forward. Find March. Can they blow him up in time? No. He's going to get the walk away.
Oh, he
does get bought down. Okay. No more Shaker. They can maybe take this fight, but Gabby, oh, he's already switched over into it. And now the chase down looking for PYW. Yule Scepter lift up, has the BKB available. He's going to turn onto him now and is trying to take down that Omni Knight. Meanwhile, the jump forward looking for the follow-up onto Ori. He has a DD turning now onto that Morphling. They're not going to be able to bring him down. This fight's looking a little bit tense for TNC. So Armel gets chased.
Yeah, Ori kind of got isolated on the other side of the river.
Jump of surprise.
Right.
We do have that level 20 on Ori as well with the dispel.
Down, no he dispels. Goes. Looking for it. Trying to find March. He's getting isolated. But on the other side, Gabby just trying to take down Urus. Waveform forward, not going to be enough. March is still walking away. He does eventually get brought down. And Gabby, he hasn't found anybody to jump on. The Static Storm is down onto nothing. VG Gamer are looking pretty good. They get the Finger of Death. Can they kill off this Morphling? Gabby does manage
Ori's
to get the
alone.
Jump away. And now Ori isolated. They are going to find that Fissure for the kill. So one for one. But the one that Vici lost is bigger.
First.
Now they're maybe doing both simultaneously. BYW there trying to force him back a little bit on Armel, but Armel is here to stay as they're going to punch into him. And now Gabby shows up. The GA is out, but I don't know if it's going to be enough as the waveform comes through. Monster comes in with the Hex to catch him. Morphling just dies. And now you've got Vici Gaming that are maybe going to look to follow this one up. KP's got to get away, but the coil comes down, and they've got him caught as well. Catching him, Fissure trying to interrupt. It ain't going to be enough. They don't have Song, and Rosh is going to Vici.
I wonder if they maybe thought...
They're going to need the help of DY to make it work for them.
I like Yang trying to find another answer, though, through... Because, like, the Hex, obviously, you try and catch it before the BKB. If he BKBs, Puck can't do anything. So that's why Yang's going to try and go for this Aghanim's. Sheeva's from our Meltus scout, trying to figure out where they're at, and Ori's in.
Ori goes in, absolutely. BKB is out in time.
Huge.
The mute. Oh, it was beautiful. Ori did it to him as they had the nullifier, now finding a bit more. That's going to be March dead as well.
They were not ready for the nullifier.
Oh, lordy, lordy. Danger town indeed for TNC as they will lose Armel. It is all false.
To try and clear out those creep waves, but the best thing that they've got for deep push right now is a glimpse, it looks like. As Yang is just on top of him. Phase shift doesn't care about the root. Urus up on high ground. They're going to use the glyph. 17 seconds until Morphling is back up. As Ichi Gaming came to play, going to take down that tier 3 tower. Now looking for a bit more as Bristle's still going to be gone for 20. And there's the coil onto Naga. Got to be careful. The chase goes Scepter. Going to be nullified. The chase down comes onto that disruptor and he is dead. Ichi Gaming now with more of an opening. Gabby, chasing, Fissure, jump through. There's gonna be the phase shift though, and the song. Oh, that's a nice way to do it. They also see the TA here though. Can they bring them both down? Looking for it. Static storm down, the mute is there, and it's gonna blow up the puck. But now the turn on to March. Glimpse Ori back over to the side. Fissure going out, KP living just barely, and Gabby seems to be able to take down the rest of these cores, but it's not gonna happen. They buy back on the Earthshaker Lion.
It's another shitty wizard.
All right, Armel sees some of those traps around. We'll take him down in a second. Oh, no, he's handed the gem back over. But he does have an inkling that, hey, Rosh could be going on.
Now this is the bold
play. Moving into the pit, and it's not going to happen. Now the turnaround, they got him caught. The jump in onto the side, blows up one DY. No chance for him to fight. Now the coil onto two, it snapped. But with the BKB still working for the more.
Predicament. It's not over quite yet.
Yeah.
What does my friend Gaven say? Does he have a 89%? That's respectable.
Oh my God.
Ichi.
Yang. Oh God. That's why. That's that percentage right there.
I don't think he can get inside to invade the Dire from the Dire team.
You got to be careful. Urus, he's revealed. He's underneath a ward. The jump in, the fissure. They got him caught, bringing him down super low and dead. Everything dropped to get that kill.
The question is, when do you blink on the buyback? They have the trap in the pit.
Oh,
they know there's no
Roche.
Found
another one. Got to be careful, though. The Hex has already come out. Can they keep him alive? This Morphine looking fine and dandy is there's going to be the TP in on top of him. The Song of the Sirens
comes in on
reset.
The song. Where's Tibbs?
Got to be careful. There's the follow-up. They blow up DY. He's out of this fight. The Leash is there onto two of them. They're going to lose March. But can they find any more kills? The buyback coming from that Lesh. Meanwhile, they just try and back out of here. They're going to buy back on the Naga and the Earthshaker who are running into this fight. EYW, seeing if he can live. Armel is in the midst of all of them. They kill off that Disruptor. He's gotten buyback
all
now.
Right, March is back.
Sure, follow Gabby looking, trying to find EY. They cut it off, but is it going to be enough? Ori trying to run away yet again. Yang, Chase, he's already used his orb. He's in a hell of a lot of trouble. Chaunce to the other side. Chase comes out. A double stun comes as well. Is it going to be there? They're bringing him down.
Gabby,
oh, silence. Gabby trying to be brought down, but he switches back over.
The Lotus
Orb. Double heal, and they get it off the kinetic field. They're in so much trouble. TNC, they bring them all down. Lesh is dead for 2 minutes, and Ori just trying to live. They're going to jump back in here in a second, possibly with Yang.
They're scouting with traps. They thought they had him with the silence, but KP's Lotus saved Gabby. KP will fall, though. He's bought back here. If he goes down, Gabby obviously loses a lot of his power. And, I mean, credit to VG, the way they've spent this big Goldie with the bot, too.
EYW, they got him caught. Needs to be careful. Broken, snap. BKB wearing off shortly.
That's
TA's coming in.
Through.
They got to be careful. The stun is going to be there in a second with the Mount Strike. Nobody jumps away because this hero is balanced. And they are going to be able to go for the reinitiation. Now they find him. Oh, trying to run away is PYW. Gets jumped on another time by Gabby. The
you
punch
gotta
comes
run.
Through. One Punch Man. There's only buyback on this TA. They're in trouble. And he's going to die. Ori dead. Buys back. But it's only him and Puck.
And it's just going to walk up high ground.
But yeah, yours does. And he's eyeing that refresher.
He's thinking about it.
They go for a song.
And the Disruptor, he's down. Static Storm is already out. They got him stunned. Ori is in trouble, and Ori is dead. 2 minutes without that TA. And now Gabby on the hunt, looking for yours, hoping to find a bit more. As yours is just trying to run away. And they find this follow-up kill. Yang went for the back lines, the coil. The Echo Slam is not going to work. Neither is the Static Storm, but it might not matter. As they're going to chase down this puck who's just trying to clear through the creep wave. Hope
for Yang. Nearly got him too.
This guy's crazy. DD bottom. They ping it. And Gabby will likely come to collect his due.
Oh my god, Yang is just...
Dude, and they got him. Yep, that's
all right,
a problem.
He's got the Aeon disc.
And he is going to be controlled in silence.
Too long, though.
It's going to bring him down. Gabby finds that kill.
Viva's TA.
Wait a minute, though. They're moving out. This is a smoked-up convoy heading across.
So slow.
And he is not going to get there in time. He has to be careful. He's still running into the pit right now. There's going to be the stun to open it up. Ori on top of Gabby. Not going to be able to find enough damage, but the GA is already there. The chase through coming. They're going to get the glimpse out and away, which means Yang is not here for this fight. He doesn't have TPs to get there. Urus is still living through it. Gabby turned upon Hex. He did manage to get the switch over, though. Is it enough? It is. They get the kill at least the first time. And now fighting the second. That's Disruptor dead. He has buyback coming back in a second. They don't time out that stun perfectly. But Urus, in that duration of the BKB with the refresher, is making it work. But Gabby is just so strong. Hard to kill. Hard to control. Dagon comes out. Another static storm on top of that puck as he is going to go into the grave. 2 minutes on the sidelines. They have buyback on Urus. And they're going to need it.
Out. QIW no will puck. Be lucky as well. He jukes the
They
ring.
Have been on the brink for so long, and now they're setting up yet again. Disruptor in the area with the static storm. He finds his man, and that's going to be the stun. Urus in some trouble. It is going to be possibly a kill if they can get it. It's no buyback, and that's 2 minutes with no Lesh. TA needs to do it all here. Do they have anything left in the tank? They find the net there. Heavenly Grace, it's not quite enough. The stun comes through, trying to bring down PYW. I don't know if it matters. On the back lines, they found themselves that TA. Ori has to buy back into this fight, seeing if they can make it happen. PYW stunned, killed off. Another run, dites the bus. That's not how that phrase goes, as Ori is going to try and do what he can, but GG is called as TNC are going to take the major.
In true TNC fashion, they managed to do it after being down. I can't even believe they now have a 25K lead. Oh. And I believe-